never uploaded it to YouTube or anything like that, so we're just gonna go ahead and start with the second one. So, yeah. Warning, I might scream. Maybe. I might just freak out. I like subtitles because I have a hard time reading. Okay. Motion. No, that's fine. Change the game a bit. Okay, I know for you guys it's gonna look brighter, but I have an energy saving TV, so I will have to make it brighter because it's very hard for me to see. Like, even if I put it completely dark, I cannot see anything. Okay, so, I think that's all I need to do for now. Let's go ahead and just start this game. First time playing, we'll just start with this. Lynn Lagerman is an investigative journalist seeking the answers behind a pregnant woman murdered under impossible circumstances in rural Arizona. You are Blake Lagerman, her husband, assistant, and cameraman. Record everything. Neither of you are fighters. To navigate the horrors awaiting for you in the desert, your only choices are to run, hide, or die. Grace unto you, but never peace. I mean, I've played the demo, so this will be interesting to actually finally get to play the whole game. First one, wow. Move. Okay. Dreaming about somebody I haven't seen since childhood. It's weird. Okay. There's a guy. Follow him. You know, you never should follow the guy, but when in doubt in this game, you do.
Find Lynn. Nothing matters but Lynn.
Oh, okay. This is a cool way for us to do this. I can review footage. Oh, that is really cool. Okay, so that's completely different from the first one. Like, before it was just look at files and stuff, but now you can actually look at your video camera. That is really cool. Okay, that's cool. Alright, cool. How do you pull out the camera? Okay, that's moving myself. Oh, there we go. Okay, so that button pulls out the camera. Okay, how do you zoom in? Oh, there we go. Okay. That's the night vision. Okay, well, we don't want to use that because I don't want to use my battery. Okay, so that's how we record things here now. Okay.
Oh, shit! Jesus! Is... No, there's no bodies. She's not in here. Lynn!
Where the pilot's body at? He was in there. Okay, apparently the pilot just vanishes. Okay.
Oh, fuck me! Fuck!
Oh.
That did not happen in the crash. Fuck this. Lynn.
That's the pilot. Oh. Oh, wow. I can't see. I don't want to use my batteries, though.
I'm lost and hurt. Anybody there? Please. Hey. Hey, man. Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
I can't bear what we've done, happened. Not being apart from our little one. So I'm going over and hoping you forgive me for leaving you behind, and God forgives me. I know that they had to be offered up, but I am all torn up inside and can't live no more. Hopefully the end will come soon and we can be together again, unless God burns me forever for this sin. Until then, I hope you find what woman's comfort you need in the arms of Papa. Yours forever, Tom.
Who's...
God continues to bless me with visions, and I know more certain than ever that the enemy is nearer with every day. I was scrubbing the stains from the floor of Daniel's room when the blessed music rose inside me and sank me into this true sight when I saw a creature like the burning sun, but with inward rings of teeth upon teeth and dangling beneath limbs that I took to be arms, but were cogs that rose in chilling purpose. And as its monstrous sun descended, it fucked the earth and birthed some great and slouching horror from the fire. I was filled with the same fear, so great that I could not breathe nor move, and saw myself all those years back, blinding Daniel with a lie and trying to keep, but could not. And when I woke, I found myself wet with lusting, painful desires to feel a man inside me, and the feeling was not so far different from the fear. I tried to comfort myself with your teachings, terror is as joy in the movement of God, but I would take greater comfort in your manhood inside me, in a firm prayer that he, Antichrist, be strangled in my womb. Most faithful of yours, I can't read this, flock in holy longing, Lisa. Oh, I can heal myself.
Find
now.
Lynn. Nothing matters but Lynn.
Oh, that's cool. Okay, so apparently even using the camera in non-mode thing actually uses the battery.
That's fucked up.
Babies. Oh my god, that's freaking out. Okay. Ah, the camera wink. Huh. Oh no. Do I seriously have my brightness up? Because, like, it is super, super hard for me to see. Yeah, I got as bright as it will go. Dang, it's just so hard to see. Like, not even a little way.
Sir. gelatinous nibicante.
Oh my God! want to go that way because I don't know where to go. Oh my god. Forget this, I'm just running past her. How do you get past her? There's like nothing to hide up in here.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. Lead the wench before hell after birth.
know she found me. Run, 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 run! Oh god, run. Just run! Playing this game with you. No, oh my god, it's that window right there. You're a witch. I know where to go. I can't get in there. Come on, I'm not playing with you anymore. This is not cool!
Oh my god.
Made war in the fields of my son and parents is my land lay waste, but my steed firmly set against Babylon and Assyrian and against Rome, but fallen to the Muslim and failed in the Crusades and betrayed in the time of the public races. As it was written by Watchman Drone in the words of the weeping Jeremiah, the prophet's prophecy falsely and the priest bear and shame, and my people love to have it so. Be them instructed, O Israel, lest my soul depart from thee. Let not the face be. I cannot read these in the blah blah blah. I cannot read the rest of this. It's just so tiny to read. So here, we'll just do it. There you go. Be thou instructed, O Israel, lest my soul depart from thee. Let not thy face be. Circumcised in thy dermod, thou must not weep, not be tears, thou must weep as one blood. And Sullivan not inscribed his name as Ixchel upon attorney's banner with iron blade. He scratched the word eye down the globe of his face, or his eye, and it was slit in blood. His face was washed with tears and blood. Thus saith the true Lord, now may I show you the truth, for you have cut thine face. Thine eye, but the scale you took from an eye, and now you may see. Okay.
Jesus!
Who? Then you have
God wants me dead? Okay.
Raging. Hide you in the blood. Hide you in the blood. Till the day.
This mountainous arm was desolate. Fox walk upon it.
Sing from.
His father and mother knew not. For he sought an occasion against the Philistines.
Thank you.
through Forsaken. I will turn unto thee, turn thou unto us, and we shall return. These were the words of lamentation. New ideas.
Find Lynn. Nothing matters but Lynn.
Let's see. Paul, as you got Papa Knoff's ear, I'm asking that you tell him a worrisome story that I hope is only my fears and the thing factual. The chief among his decons, Val, came to him before sunrise this morning with an offer that was not fully described. Val did like somebody offering something secret and sexual in nature. But by my knowledge of Val and his character, it's frightening. Val would not further explain and told me that there are places in our hearts Papa Knoth cannot reach. Though truth be told, Val seemed more interest in other areas of my body. I asked Val to return this evening once I had a chance to think it over, but it is only so that Knoth may send some men of character to secretly witness what I suspect is blasphemy, and betrayal and cut it off before any harm is done. I hope Papa can help, as I am dreadfully scared. Ruth.
Oh, wow.